Hello, everybody, and welcome to another edition of Dungeon Rollers. Bum, bum, bum. I'm being very dramatic today. But today, our adventurers are going to continue on their journey to... Wait, what just happened? Oh, for the love of God. Why is it... Yeah, it occasionally... Okay, occasionally, my map will pick up the wrong... What? Okay, hold on. I need to fix that.
It's a very small map. And I can see things I'm not meant to see.
Right? That is why I do this. Let's go to studio mode and try and fix that, shall we?
It's fine on my point of view.
I don't know.
Is that the right one?
No, yeah, we saw it on the stream.
I had a stream open.
Oh, no, I didn't. I was getting my own sorted.
For love of God, it's not reading that page is open. Oh, well, time to close that one and reopen it. So anyway... Why is it always this stream? Every other stream, it's just like, go. And this is the one that always has the issues, and I don't know why.
Because there's a lot to set up. It's just...
There is a lot of setup.
The chance of mistakes.
There's a lot of people.
I've had this set up for the last hour, waiting on people to join so I could get the... You know, get the names and all that in the right position. Why is the one thing that's messing up right now the freaking,
Did you check it before you went live, or is it...
Yes. Yes, I did.
And now it just decided to swap
it just wants to fuck you over.
I know, right? Okay, we're almost back. Please excuse these technical difficulties, ladies and gentlemen. So we are transitioning over. Cool, we have our map. That was fun. Hi, everybody. So today our adventures are going deeper and deeper and deeper into the story. We're joined the only one on the right hand side of the screen, Zelfana, played by Zoe.
I'm all alone.
We have Zilk, played by Trip.
Hey there.
We have Idris, played by the very distracted Diator.
Hi, everybody. Bunnies are being cute as fuck, is why.
And we have Yuzaria, who is played by Turtle.
I'm insane.
You're not insane, yes, Yuzaria is. Who wants...
Debatable.
Who wants to give us a recap?
Trip's turn. Trip has done it sessions 2, 3, 4.
Zelfana.
And then I passed it off to someone else last time.
Zelfana, your turn.
Yeah, nice try. That's not gonna happen.
Alright, I can do it. So, we decided, you know what? It's time for us to face the hag problem head on. And as we were leaving the tavern to do so, she showed up with a meeting place to discuss resolving our issue. What she wanted from us was entertainment. And we are currently in a dungeon in the ethereal realm.
Are you not entertained?
For her entertainment. We have fought a gelatinous cube, lots of smelly undead, and we have a very mentally troubled Yuzaria who has decided to snap all of their arrows.
Except for one.
Except
for one.
Except for one. All of the bow. Chekhov's arrow.
That's a good synopsis.
A lot of children's bones, to be precise as well.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I collected some.
Yeah, that's going to be fun to explain to yourself later. Okay, so...
If they get the chance.
That's gonna be a fun thing to explain at parties later.
Right? What'd you do in the dungeon? Oh, I picked up kids' bones.
What?
Hey, that's a nice bow. What's it made out of?
Children's femurs.
I might imagine them in the future shooting and wounding someone, and someone be like, what kind of arrow is this? Like, is this a bone arrow? And they just go... No, specifically, it's a child's bone arrow.
Yep.
And then pulls it out of their shoulder.
So you wake
That's
up.
How I imagine it.
You wake up in this, what appears to be a safe space, right?
Appears.
Well, do you want me to just flat out say it's a safe space, or do you want some mysterious things? Anyway, you wake up. Nobody was haunted last night. except Yuzaria, because Yuzaria is currently insane. Yuzaria is heard all night, kill your dragon, kill your dragon, kill your dragon, all night long. And the first thing she sees when she wakes up is her dragon kind of like poking his, my stream's offline. Okay, there we go. Come on. We're green.
I've always been insane.
We're green. Anyway, like I was saying, sorry about that, everybody. So the first thing that Yuzaria sees in the morning is Mysum's face kind of looking at hers really close. Oh my god, it did it again.
Your map is fucked up again.
Oh my god.
Oh no.
This is going so well.
Okay, anyway, we're just going to continue while I fix this. You see your dragon's face in your face when you wake up. Go.
Yep.
I suck!
What? That's what I do. I just stutter at him.
Fair enough. What's everybody doing?
Having a big old stretch after I went to bed almost dead fucking yesterday.
Almost?
Yeah.
I didn't do a good job then.
I had 2 health on it, you know this.
I didn't also, do a good
I love
job then.
You I love how you described it as well.
Huh?
I love how Dio described, I don't swear so I won't replicate it. But just the way he said how he went to bed just was like, he couldn't remember words and it was funny.
Ah, fair enough. All right, so y'all wake up, you're refreshed, you had a long rest. Paulin apparently stayed on guard all night.
Yeah, I forgot to move her into the
space. Yeah, you did.
I did. Guess what Trip forgets to do at the start of every session?
Prepared spells.
Yep. I always remember everything else.
It's tradition at this point.
It is.
Also, if you're having issues with the stream, refresh your stream if I am not showing up. Okay. We're here.
I am not show up.
Happy Pride Month. We're here. Deal with it.
Yeah.
Stuff.
What games?
Oh shit, I've got to do my funny bit.
What?
Ignore me. I've had a bit planned for 3 days and I forgot to do that. No. No, it's fine because this is the day I was supposed to do it. I'm just glad I remembered.
Alright. Let's see what the players do.
Where's Trip? Oh, Zilk's hiding under the... Yeah, okay. Sorry.
Zilk actually went in the tent.
Idris just kind of fell
asleep. Sleeping in a tent like a weirdo. Real people sleep on children's bones.
We might have different definitions of real people, man. suffice it to say, yes, it seems you're still kind of, what's the word, mentally afflicted?
I'm fine.
Okay, so we'll deal with the issue with the children's bones later. What's the next step? We're here, we're awake, what do we hit next?
She didn't mess with you overnight.
I wager it's time for us to keep going in this here dungeon and get to its conclusion and see if she's entertaining.
He just walks into the room where we had the big fight with the whatever we killed last time and sees if there's anything in there.
You see a pile of bones. You see a very tiny fairy dragon floating around. you see a bunch of dead bodies.
Okay.
I'm sorry, you don't see the bodies because they were raised, so they disappeared. Or they weren't raised. Yeah, they disappeared.
He just shouts back into the room, "It's how we left it," and then just kind of walks towards the next garden.
Okay. So, as you walk towards that corridor, and you have no idea what that room is actually part of.
Totally not.
Well, you're not even able to see it yet. Idris, walk forward!
I was wondering if anybody else was gonna do anything.
Would you mind if I,
La, 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 la,
la. I'll, excuse me, Idris, if you wouldn't mind, I would like to try and, sneak into this next area.
Idris says, okay, but you know that thing where two people go to let each other pass and both move the same way, like, three or four times?
Oh!
That happens.
Alright, may I roll stealth?
Yeah, roll stealth.
And unlike last session, I remembered I have advantage on stealth checks now.
Yay!
Thank you, my POV, for reminding me of that. I got a natural 20.
Alright, so you are 99.99999% sure that you are hidden. As you walk into the room, you see a room that is surrounded by candles on the outside and a giant upside-down pentacle in the middle of the floor. There are ingredients, like different spell focuses and that, just spread all around the floor, discarded. None of them usable, but you can tell what they used to be. And also there are patches of blood there as well. I couldn't find a good blood patch.
You can tell I'm neurodivergent because I've literally just been tracing around the star, like, in a loop the entire time it's been on screen and just having the time of my life.
I started doing that.
Back to the previous room and says, "Guys, Zilk just disappeared."
And you think I'm insane?
Zilk probably knows that looking around, like, okay, we might need to use this room later, unfortunately. But I'm gonna nip up here.
So as you so elegantly put it, you nip up there and you see this. And you also hear a voice say, a very familiar voice say, "Yes, come on in."
I'm gonna take a little peek around the corner.
I was allowed to. I would have played the funny sound effect.
So as you peek around the corner, you see...
What is that?
A room. A very odd...
Oh.
A very odd looking room.
What the hell is that?
That's a Baskin rug by the looks of it.
Could also just be a giant dragon turd.
Oh shit, it's my dad. Hi, Dad.
Idris walks into the room, looks around, and sees the two candles in the middle, and then moves them to the middle because they frustrate him that they're not in the middle. And then just carries on walking into the next room a little bit.
Okay. What?
Dad.
Everybody nice and happy.
What the fuck?
Yuzaira just stands in the middle of the pentagram because it's Yuzaira, and apparently she's under the pentagram because you can't see her anymore.
Oh, thank God. Hold on. I fix. Give me a minute.
Holy shit, you guys. Yuz just disappeared.
New side quest going through the layers of hell to get Yuzaria back.
Oh, we find Yuzaria. She's not, like, trapped. She's just chilling.
There you go.
Okay, so can I tell what this is from where I am?
Nope. That's all the information you get on it.
What does Zilk see? Like, can you describe this? Because I
can't physically
tell what this looks like.
It is a, not, like, blindingly bright, but it is a bright room You can tell it's an oddly dimensioned room as well. The walls have a couple different, like, paintings on them. Looking like, you know, painters from literally eons. You can tell by, like, the brushstrokes and that. There is... Yeah, it's just almost like a long, welcoming hall.
It seems like... This is me whispering to Idris. It seems like we might have reached our destination.
Idris toots a little because he didn't know Zub was there. But it kind of scared him a little bit.
Idris hears a voice. A very familiar voice.
Why are you hiding out there? Come on in.
Keep your wits about you. And Zub's gonna... start walking down the hallway.
Where is the paintings, Anna?
No, you are not stealing the paintings.
God damn it.
No art theft for you.
But I wanna them.
Because I didn't plan on the paintings, okay?
Do I see correctly in the bottom that Yuz and Zelthana are dancing on the pentagram?
Yes.
Yeah. Fancy shit.
We're having the time of our lives.
Zero divergent behavior right
just
here.
Just figured out you can move the tokens with the arrow keys, and it's fun.
Resist the temptation, resist the temptation.
So, Zoe, or you, Zelthana, while you're dancing around, you just hear...
No, we're
hear,
not. This is, I'm just
are,
fucking about.
You
I'm
hear,
not actually doing
it. You hear
I'm doing
a
it,
foreign
though.
Voice... say, why did you abandon Ella?
Oh, that's not nice. Is this just like a thing that only Zell hears?
Yep, only you.
Gotta love the ethereal voices.
Yeah, Pollen.
Hi, Pollen.
I'm gonna say that Zelthana reacts very internally. Because I have a feeling she might be hearing thoughts like this for a while.
As Idris rounds the corner, he sees a familiar figure sitting behind a stone desk on a stone throne.
Oh, it's a Baskin Rock.
I did say that ages ago.
This figure is a smaller for its species bronze dragonborn with burning red eyes. Only stands about, you know, like when I say short for a dragonborn, this creature is 5'8" ish. And yeah, she's sitting there behind the desk, looks dead at Idris, and says, "It's about time I see you again."
Hi, Jerry. What happened to your eyes? They were purple before.
Sweat. Wait, Jerry?
J-H-E-R-I, Jerry.
Okay, alright, cool.
It's in my backstory, Anna.
Yeah.
I
know.
Like the questioning wasn't the name. It was the pronunciation based on that spelling.
Yeah, it works.
So bad.
So Jerry looks at you with the eyes. Well, that's what happens when you leave somebody to die in a fire. They tend to not make it.
Did someone say fire?
And you see her, lift up, like, the hem of her sleeve and just roll it kind of up, and you see that her skin is literally just completely blackened. You see, it's so blackened, you see, like, cuts running through it, and you see just the burnt flesh underneath.
I mean, you know I try. It wasn't my fault.
If you would have tried, you would have ended up saving me. That's what would have happened. But no, you ran away. That's what you did.
No, that's...
That's not how it happened.
That is how it happened.
See,
I watched you. I was still alive watching you when you walked away.
Seeing his friend Idris in distress, Zilk is also going to round the corner, figuring this is an illusion of some sort.
As Zilk rounds the corner, all of a sudden this figure who's staring intently at Idris, the head comes over to you, and just like this mist forms up and then flows down from it, revealing a very gruff-looking... hold on.
Half-orc.
Yeah, half-orc. Thank you. I did all of these, now I gotta look them back up. But a very gruff, large half-orc sitting in there. And in his hands is a bear trap. Hands. Her hands is a bear trap. And she's kind of dangling it from a chain. And she just goes, I see I have another chance to finish the job.
Well, we both know that you're not real, but, hey, Elster, it's been a while.
Oh, I'm not real?
I don't think the real Elkdar would ever come underground if not for a hunt, and there's nothing here you hunt, so...
Oh, there's plenty to hunt. I've been tracking you for a long time. It'll be nice to feast on your flesh.
Well,
Binky.
Zilk is obviously a bit thrown off seeing Elkdar again, but also he's like trying to remain like intelligent and like on point and not let it throw him off too bad.
Roll a deception check.
Okay.
Just for funsies.
Okay, I was gonna say, what am I being deceptive about?
Actually, no, do a theater check, whatever the theater check one is.
Performance,
there we go.
13.
Okay, so this half-orc just kind of smiles and goes, you know it's true, don't you? You know I've been after you for a long time. Now to finish the job.
Explanation to my compatriots here. Meet Elkdar. Well, this is what Elkdar looks like.
Idris kind of goes, that's my sister, Jerry.
So you see this figure look over and sees Zalfana peeking around the corner. And all of a sudden, again, that mist forms just flows back down. And you see this pale-skinned person, roughly 6 feet, with brown eyes and very long, just flowing hair, sitting behind the desk and looks at Zelthana and goes, it's been a while.
Okay, hold on.
I'm under the best in rock! Whoops.
Okay. I'm trying. Sorry, my brain isn't working today, and I'm trying to figure out what I want to do. Okay, I'm gonna do something stupid and impulsive because I think it'll be funny. Can I cast a spell at? I'm not gonna say the name, but who the thing is illusion. I can't speak English. Somebody help me.
You want to cast a spell aimed at the illusory figure?
Thank you.
Okay, cast the spell. What are you casting? What are you doing?
Do I have... Yeah, I should have my spell slots. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna cast Scorching Ray because fire.
Because fire! 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 Okay.
I think it's the only fire thing I have that can hit at this range and not hit anyone else.
Alright, throw that... Throw that spell. Cast it.
12.
So as you prepare this spell and you cast it out to him, the figure just holds their hand up and literally just the spell just dissipates about 10 feet before it even gets close to the figure.
don't forget that Scorching Ray, you roll three times because it's three blasts.
I was about to say, but I have a feeling the same thing is going to happen every time.
There's a very good chance it does.
I'm going to roll anyway. I like those odds. All right.
All right.
I like those odds.
21?
So, whoa, wait, hold up. That's wrong. Hold on. Please hold. I'm looking for a dice. There it is. Okay, so as you cast, all of a sudden, the cup on Zilk's yeah, belt.
I'm doing the cup. Right,
I know.
Now. It did actually get cupped.
Yeah, it did on my end too.
God damn.
So you see the spell kind of do a 180 and straight into the cup.
All right, blast three. Let's do this.
I rolled three times and the first two got cupped, the third one did not. So
19.
Okay, so you see the figure holds their hand up, and this time the blast gets within 5 feet before it dissipates.
Ooh, okay. So you're saying if I try again.
And the figure just looks at you and goes, "What's wrong, Zelthana? Do you not remember Mella? Do you really want to kill me?"
Zelthana is just gonna stare straight with just like a fiery rage. She's not having any of this.
Not having any of this. That's a good thing. I have to actually figure out what happened to
Noticing that Zelthana is like this, Zilk's gonna go,
"Oh,
I think you underestimated the patience of my compatriots. As showing us the figures we fear the most is, or hate the most, not all of us will show such restraint."
And the figure, still looking at Zelthana, goes, "Why did you say those things about me? You were my friend, and you just abandoned me at the end. Do you know what that did to me?"
That rhymed.
Hearing Zilk say that, he just kind of turns and says, "Does that mean it's go time?"
Before you can answer, the figure kind of glances back to you, Zarya, and you see the smoke come back up, or smoke form again, and then just cascade down. And you see a human woman, probably about 5'2"-ish, with medium dark skin and aged white hair, sitting behind this desk, a very elderly lady, and you just hear, Zarya, you broke our hearts when you left us. Please come home. There's no reason to run anymore." In fact, I even got you a present.
What did you get me?
Well, it's for everyone, actually. You see...
What is it?
You see, I'm still bored. So, say hello to my little friend. And all of a sudden, there's a burst of, like, energy popping up, and out of it steps a wraith.
Oh, Jesus.
A what?
Wraith.
A wraith.
Sorry.
Okay.
It's a wraith, my bad. Okay, this is where we roll for initiatives.
Woohoo! I have a question.
Me being completely confused why my mother's betraying me like this?
I has question.
I has answer.
For the players, who has the wand? Is it our missing player?
I think I do.
Oh, okay.
What one?
Oh, wait, there's a turn order thing.
I don't remember.
Yeah, there's a turn order thing now.
I know we were gonna get, like, have either Zell or Maddie carry it.
We could just say that I have it so that we can do things.
Have what? I'm missing
it. The wand that we got for...
Magic Circle, got it.
Yeah.
I got 19.
Oh, I haven't.
Ooh, turn order.
I have a cattail in my face.
I can't change my turn order on the turn. Oh, yes, I'm not there.
You have to. You
Why
have
did
to
Maddie
select
roll?
Your token before rolling it.
I
think Maddie is still in there from last time.
Yeah, I think that was her previous init roll.
Hang on. I'm just going to do this the old way, because F it.
Yeah.
Because I like writing, apparently. Okay, so we have that. We have Usaria. We have Zilk. We have Zell, and we have Idris. All right. Let me get mine first because I'm selfish.
You're God. You're allowed to be so.
Okay, use.
Yeah.
Initiative.
So, I'm insane. My mom just decided to give me the gift of whatever the thing
is. You still roll initiative. Like, this is a mechanic.
Oh, yeah, I have. I thought,
15.
Thank you, Zill.
I thought
Zill.
You wanted to know what I'm doing.
No,
13.
Thank you, Zell.
10.
Thank you, Idris.
19.
Thank you. So we have a turn order. Cool. All right, Idris, what are you doing?
Well, Idris is a bit confused and angry that this person has shapeshifted a few times and dared take pictures of his sister. So, of course, Idris is gonna rage.
Fair enough.
D&D Beyond has got Pride logo.
What?
Yeah, I'm on D&D Beyond looking something up, and they changed their logo on the website to be Pride themed.
And sees the thing, but is more confused by what's going on over here. So he's gonna sprint forward. 10, 15, 20.
When you hit, please hold.
I haven't.
Why are you not allowing me to select? Am I on the wrong layer? I'm on the wrong layer. Yes, I am. Hello. So when you hit here, you are stopped.
Okay.
You are stopped by an invisible barrier.
Idris kind of goes, Silk, I can't run any further forwards.
And you hear a slight, you hear a cackle from behind it, just and then again the smoke comes up and back down, turns into your sister, and you just hear, why are you doing this?
Well, you're not Jerry. Runs forward and just smacks the shit out of the ground.
Since Idris talked to Zilk, Zilk's gonna respond. I am under the impression, because we took the deal to attempt to entertain her, the hag in exchange for mercy, we can't harm her until we've done that. That would be logical given the magic at hand here.
Okay, 16 plus 9. Oh, my stream has
cool.
Possibly just died.
Cool.
Oh, now he's back.
Go ahead and roll for that dire damage.
Damage is 1d20. Oh boy. So that is 12 plus 7. Does 19 points of damage.
Okay.
And can little Reiki boy make a dexterity saving throw?
What is this considered?
It's a dexterity saving throw against my storm armor.
Against your stone armor?
Storm aura.
Stone
barbarian.
What's the check?
It's a.
Like, what's the DC? 14. Okay, so it has your storm or it has no effect.
It's half damage.
So what's the damage then?
One.
Okay, so you run into this thing and smash it with your axe or great axe?
Dragon Slayer.
Oh, your Dragon Slayer. And you're, it just, it's like there's some resistance, but it's very, very slight resistance as you cut through this wraith.
Obviously, it's a magical weapon, so if that matters.
No, it doesn't. Okay, so, hello. So the wraith turns to you, looks you dead in the eye, and he says, "Die!" And...
That's rude.
Yeah, very rude.
Does a... Oh my... that was a 20 hits, correct?
Yeah, just about.
So, you take... 17 necrotic damage, and can you do a constitution save, please?
Wow.
Yikes.
Not 20.
Okay, so... This wraith reaches out to you and touches...
24.
Okay, this wraith reaches his hand out and touches your arm, and you just feel the life kind of just drain out of you. You see this wicked smile, but you're able to kind of like shake off the, this isn't my life. This is, you know, I can take this. Next person is Yuzaria.
With, oh god, what insane bullshit is going to happen here.
With her one arrow...
Okay, hear me out. I may only have one arrow, but I still have a short sword.
That's true. That's very true.
Shoot the short sword!
I don't think that'll work very well. Because I don't like the thing, I try to attack it, but because I am still very scared of somehow managing to kill my own dragon, I leave him behind, like, he just has to stay here behind the wall.
Okay.
I, however, go, like... I think that should be fine if I go... yeah. Stuff. I go over to there.
Alrighty.
Yes.
Yes.
And I try to attack it with my short sword. We'll see how that goes.
Let's see how it goes. All right.
Why does it say plus two? Oh, what? But.
I don't know, just. Dex plus your proficiency, so it's 26.
Okay. So yeah, 26.
Proficient sword swords? That
doesn't sound
right. You hit.
They are proficient in sword swords. I'm not sure why it has the plus two at the top, though.
Yeah, that's really
I've never
weird.
Seen it do that for a weapon roll.
Oh, well. Anyway, roll for damage.
Damage? Nine piercing.
Plus? Oh, nine piercing? Okay. Wonderful. Oh, god. Damn it, I didn't do that right. Ignore that, folks. The stream's still going on. All right. Next is Zilk.
Alrighty. I'm going to start by using a bonus action to use the wild shape charge to make pollen combatable.
All right. Pollen is combatable now.
I'm going to move.
That's my new favorite adjective.
I'm going to slide down here. As I ready a dagger, I'm going to ask the illusionary creature. So, after we deal with this wraith, we talk business now, correct?
You see the creature transforms once again into the trapper and goes, "We'll see."
I'm gonna throw.
at the wraith.
Okay.
That's a terrible throw. 14.
It hits.
Oh, lovely. Damage time. Plus 1d6 because I'm in the dragon aura. For a total 13.
Okay.
And Pollen is going to use its greater invisibility, as it always does, and is going to move down here and ready an action if the wraith approaches.
Cool. Cool, ending cool, cool.
Its turn and my turn.
All right. Zell.
Let's go. Let's just do an Eldritch Blast.
Let's do an Eldritch Blast.
Can't remember.
The cup does not nom. I have rolled.
Yeah, can you like? No, okay, no, hold on. There.
That's still in range.
That's still in
range.
10-foot radius.
I thought it was 5 foot.
It's no, 10 foot.
10 foot. It's specifically slightly bigger so that way it does it. It's a cursed item. It can protect me, but also can frick over you guys. There you go.
Now you're. I will count that as well as you're still within the dragon aura.
Cool. I forgot what that does.
Plus 1d6.
On your damage, yeah.
Yeah. Is it every attack you make on the turn or one attack?
Every attack you make.
Liddy.
Eldritch Blast! 23.
That hits.
1d10 plus 4 force, 5 force, and then plus d6?
Yep, plus the d6.
6, so for a total of 11.
Okay, we're back up to Idris.
Idris really didn't like the little shithead touching him, so he's gonna fucking hit him again.
Hit away. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot flavor text for Zell. So you see this blast go in, and it kind of, like, almost goes to the center of the wraith. Instead of, like, hitting the skin, it, like, hits the core, and you just see the wraith kind of just shrug and looks at you in the eyes for a second. Excuse me, for a second.
Daring contest, bitch. Let's go.
All right. Sorry about that.
14 plus 9.
It hits.
That's 11 plus 7. 18.
So 18 damage?
Plus a dex saving throw.
You said 14 damage, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
11 plus 7 damage, 18.
Okay. 18 damage.
7, 11?
Dex saving throw 14.
Cool. What's the half? What's the damage on that?
5.
All right. So you see this thing. Is that math right? That math right. So you swing at this thing, and again, there's very little resistance, but there is some resistance in there. And as your storm aura, like, you see the lightning from your storm aura just wrap around it and barely miss. But enough, it hits enough so that, he feels it a little bit, but doesn't hit completely. But he does look at you again and kind of smiles at you with his dead eyes. And... Ooh. Where is it? that definitely hits, but 24?
Yeah. Just.
Oh, dear God.
Oh, God.
So, 24 damage.
Oh, boy.
Can you make a DC 4 constitution save?
9 plus 4. 13.
Okay, so again, you feel the, like, the life draining out of where he touches you from, and you're able to shake it off like, I gotta stay here, you know, I'm centered, I'm focused, I'm raging. Okay, it is now Yuza's turn. Oh, you're fine, Idris. You're fine.
Oh, I didn't take the... What was that? 24?
24. Oh, you didn't take that off yet?
Nope.
Uh-oh, Scooby.
Not good. Not doing so hot, Anna.
You aren't. No, you're not.
The thing is...
Bad times.
This would be a good time to switch tanks.
Ow! Like, I could do a spell, but I'm insane. I can't do spells while I'm insane. Like, it doesn't feel very insane-y.
Roll a percentile dice.
So, D100?
D100, yes. You cannot
14.
Cast... Yeah, you cannot cast any spells.
Okay. Well, that's settled. I'm gonna do my short sword again.
Okay, you do your short sword. Wait.
No. 26 again.
Alright, that hits. What kind of damage are we looking at?
9 piercing again.
Alright. Cool. Anything else this turn?
See, I would involve my dragon, but I'm scared I will somehow end up hurting him because I'm insane.
Yeah,
but
so
you,
no.
You also see that Idris is, like, in between swings. Yeah, there's blood running out of his mouth. There's a little blood running out of his ear.
Ow.
Yeah, he's not looking too good. So.
Player knowledge, not far off 10% health.
Yeah.
Ow.
So.
In 2 fucking hits. Come on.
Can I?
Yeah, down.
Zilk, seeing Idris's state and Yuzaria's hesitation in combat, Zilk and Draconic is going to go, I know you're going through a lot. I know you're scared for your dragon. The dragon's going to enter this fight if you're going to survive it. Trying to get through to her.
I will say that, okay, well, just roleplay it out.
What if I hit him?
When in doubt, Yuzaria, roll percentile dice. Above 50% is good, below 50% is bad.
I don't like decision. I like dying.
Oh, that's bad.
Oh, well, looks like you don't get through to me.
But my, yeah. Apparently you don't.
Alright.
Sucks. Sorry.
It's alright.
I will do anything to keep my dragon from being hurt, and that includes not involving him in a fight, I guess.
I understand. Let's do what we gotta.
Yay. I guess that's my turn over, no?
Alright, Zilk. You're up.
And Zilk's do what we gotta is unfortunately Zilk moving into melee range.
Alright.
As Pollen moves into a wall.
She's small enough.
I've got the Wraith flanked, so I'm just gonna go all at it with my knife.
You go all at it with them there knives.
16 to hit on the first stab. 28 on the bonus action follow-up, which is a crit.
Yeah, hits, roll for damage for the first one.
Take it.
Okay, roll for damage on the second one and double it.
Because I can use which stab to use my sneak attack on, I'm going to use it on the second one for
fair enough
obvious reasons. Alright, so that is 12 plus 22.
Damn. Alright, so as you stab into this thing, you feel very little resistance, but as you pull out that second stab, you hear it just howling pain. Just, and just stares at you. Like, actually turns around and just starts staring at you. And you know exactly what's going to happen next on his turn.
Thankfully, the fairy has to take its turn.
Oh yeah, that's right. I apologize.
I've never needed a D10 to not roll a 1 or a 10 more in my life. My pollen is going to use its once per summon casting of mirror image on me.
Okay.
If I succeed this roll. And I did. It's a 3.
Ooh.
I am now mirror imaged. Well, I'm not mirror imaged. It's making a mirror. No, that's major image. I need mirror image. Thank you. I am mirror imaged. There are now 3 Zilks standing in front of this wraith. One's real. He can't tell which. Each time a creature attacks you during the duration, roll a d20 to determine whether attack hits you or a duplicate. If you have 3 duplicates, you must roll a 6 or higher to change the attack to a duplicate. Oh, I roll when I get attacked, basically.
All right. Cool.
So now, in a puff of magical fairy magic, there are 3 Zilks standing in front of this wraith.
Every time you talk, it's going to be in triplicate. You know that, right?
Yes.
That's so cool.
Okay, so Zell, it is your turn.
Jesus Christ.
If it helps, you guys can't hit the duplicates.
Excellent. I'm gonna move down a little bit.
Because you have to be trying to attack me for a duplicate to put itself in the way.
You know, I could actually be kind of mean with that duplicate, but I'm not gonna.
If they don't actually take up space, they actually all share the same space as me.
But you also duplicated the cup 3 times.
No, it's just me. Just a creature.
Like I said, I'm not doing anything with that, but no. You did duplicate the cup 3 times.
But it specifically duplicates a creature. So, if I had a magic item, I wouldn't be able to trigger it from any of those locations.
Okay, cool.
Because in...
So I'm clear.
You are
in previous versions, you could do that.
Yeah.
You could mirror image yourself to use an item 3 times.
All right. Zell, what you doing?
I am gonna go for a chill touch.
You go for that chill touch.
It does not get nommed. I got a 3 again.
The luckiness of the nom. Hi, Mika.
Okay.
Anna says hi.
Hi.
Nice butt.
Anna says nice butt.
Anyway.
I didn't put PG-13 in my title this time, guys.
Wait. No. You see, I said the PG-13 version of it. Anyway,
I'm getting flashbacks to if you don't know what my wiggle means.
Alright, I see. So you're doing icy touch.
I'm doing chill touch, and I'm just...
Chill touch.
Is it, undead?
It is undead.
Sweet, okay. If this works, then extra things happen. 25.
It hits.
1d8. It's 2 necrotic damage plus a thing because I'm next to my son!
Yep. You get the 1d6?
Your son!
Plus another 2. That's, that's 4 necrotic damage and... if you hit an undead target, it also has disadvantage on attack rolls against you until the end of your next turn. That probably won't happen because I'm furthest away, but still.
Yep. So that would be 4 total?
Four necrotic damage.
Okay, so you see, this icy hand come out and touch the shoulder of this thing, and all of a sudden, like, the vapor that makes up his body is kind of like not, it's not as solid. It's very wavy, and it looks like it's kind of hard keeping it. It's kind of hard for it to keep it together. Idris.
Idris, a bit pissed that he's been hurt so hard, and a bit confused at why he's raging and taking so much damage. He's just gonna kind of spit a little blood on the back of the wraith, and then bring the axe on, down on the back of his skull.
Okay.
You have advantage to attack because you are flanking.
Correct.
Yes, 16 plus 9.
It hits.
And then, that was a 7.
Okay.
Plus 7, so 14 damage and a little dex save.
So, as your sword goes, or as your axe goes through him, you see just, like, the part of, like, the halves that you made actually kind of float away from each other, and then just in a puff of smoke just disappear.
Okay. Yay. And then so the shock just fizzles away.
Yeah, shock just spits them.
You just spits blood on the floor again.
Since the mirror image is still here, all three Zilks turn to who looks like Alkadar. Are you impressed yet?
Nice. Very nice. And you see, once again, the fog just appears and just washes down, and you see this grizzled, like, 900-year-old walking mummy-skinned person, a woman sitting at the desk, hood pulled up over her head. She just goes, very nice. But there's one more thing. Yuzaria! And she snaps her fingers.
What the fuck do you want?
And she snaps her fingers. Yuzaria, can you roll me? Let's see what check that would be.
Good.
I'm looking at your sheet. Do a... Arcana check. Just do an Arcana check. Screw it.
Okay.
I don't know what it would actually be.
17.
Okay, so you feel this pull on you to follow her commands, and no matter how hard you fight it, no matter how hard you fight it, your body just kind of moves without your permission to hear. And the Night Hag looks at you and goes, you have been a wonderful, wonderful addition to my entertainment. Thank you so much. But now, as all that darkness has seeped into your soul, I believe I'm going to take it. And she reaches to her belt, pulls up the orb, the green orb, and looks at Idris and goes, you, Idris, if you want this orb, kill Yuzaria.
Idris just kind of looks at the Night Hag, looks at Yuzaria, looks at Zilk, kind of
the three
looking
Zilks.
Looks at the three Zilks, like one at a time. And kind of goes, what do I? What do it? ?
Not strong enough of will, are we, to do it on your own? That's perfectly fine. You see, and she kind of starts tucking the orb back. You see, this means nothing to me. I'll probably end up destroying it.
Well.
Is this in triplicate?
This is in triplicate.
Okay.
Hag of unknown name.
My name is Yennefer.
Well, Yennefer. As the zilks surround you, Zarya, and the one politely pushes past Idris, we have had quite a battle of fates lately. You've corrupted my friend's soul here, and I care for her deeply. However, the danger you pose on us is greater than the danger you pose on this kingdom. Well, other way around. You pose a greater danger to this kingdom than you do to us. Without that orb, there's no chance to free this place. So I'll give you a deal. My party here wants to slay you, obviously.
Obviously.
And, since you don't seem to be playing by the rules, this Zilk is going to try to approach the Night Hag to see if the bubble is still there.
Bubble is still there. It bounces you back.
And it appears we have no choice than to take the soul from within you, Zarya. And I assume you want in that little bag of yours, right?
Why, like, yes.
Corrupted pieces of people who once were. However, it is I do this, I need more than the orb.
It is so much fun to corrupt a soul. You should try it sometime. Especially a pure soul like you, Zarya. It was so nice to see all those dreams of hers go up in smoke.
Okay.
What do you want?
If I'm gonna take her life, I need the orb, and I need one other thing.
What is that? And she actually puts the orb right on the desk right in front of her.
I need that orb, plus I need to be able to keep the body so she may have a proper hero's burial, as well as, you know, I'm a young fae. I'm still gaining power.
Mm-hmm.
I want your fae's touch. Give me the ability to teleport like other fae. Give me the orb, let me bury her body, and I'll kill her right here.
Counteroffer, for an assurance that I will not attack you again, and I will leave you alone, I will give you the orb, I will give you the useless meat sack, and I will tell you where to start to learn, for I cannot teach.
And could I have your cool sack? Like, she had a dagger on her belt earlier, right?
Did she?
We'll just say
why not?
I want your sacrificial fey blade.
Oh, this. And she pulls up a blade, and it's one of those blades that's like wavy, so it's like just curved, with a bone handle. She sets it on the desk and kind of looks at it for a second and goes,
I would be doing this right if I killed her with a draconic bone, because then it wouldn't be a proper fey sacrifice now, would it?
You are right. So she picks up the dagger and kind of slide, like, doesn't throw it, but slides it along the ground to this Zilk over here.
All right.
Do it.
Because... alright, can we flavor that each of the Zilks can touch Zarya to make this, like, properly,
yeah.
Dramatic?
Yeah, right. Make it dramatic. I want to flare!
A Zilk is gonna bring Zarya to her feet, pin both her arms from behind. One's gonna hold, like, take the short sword, and then a Zilk is gonna stand in front of Zarya, hand on her shoulder, and go, Zarya, you have been an incredible friend to me. You helped me realize a different side of being aligned to nature, and it led to me having a dragon friend of my own. But the corruption in your mind is not just endangered us, it's endangered the thing you care about the most, myself. I do this for you, and I'm sorry, but I know you'll forgive me. Do you have anything you'd like to say before I do what I have to save not just your dragon, but this kingdom?
Thing.
Zilka's gonna give you Zarya a hug,
and plunge the dagger.
Hold on. Hold on. Before you do that, I have a feeling Zelthana has some words to say.
Would you like to... I'm sorry, I didn't think of it. The party would probably want to say goodbyes too.
Yeah.
No. Zelthana is going to say to the... you're not actually going to do this, are you?
I do what I have to, and I need you to trust me. Can you trust me this one time?
This is one giant trust check, is what this is.
Fucking hell.
This is trust to the max.
Oh, there's like actual consequences now.
Yeah.
This is fucking difficult. And I am too mentally unwell to deal with this right now.
Silk sees Zelthana struggling with it, Silk's gonna go, I'd rather show than tell. Dagger goes in the back.
As Yuzaria, so you're holding Yuzaria up, right?
Yeah.
As Yuzaria, like, kind of jerks because of the knife plunging into her back and through her heart, like, as soon as she slumps forward, a just black starts streaming out of her mouth. Like this black ghosty this black ghosty stuff, and forms into a ball that has a deep red core. And as soon as it starts to form, the night hag stands up and opens up her bag. You see,
in response to the bag opening, Zilk reaches his hand up. His hand glows with a ring you didn't notice he was wearing, and grabs the soul tight.
What is this?
I may be a young fae, but that doesn't mean I'm a fool. This soul is mine, and our deal is struck. You never specified the soul had to go into the bag, so this soul is mine. That orb is ours.
You.
And you must be gone from us and this kingdom.
She just looks incredible. Like, straight up hate is radiating anime style from her head. And she just goes, I will be reporting this to the council. And with a wave of her hand.
You do. They will be proud that I managed to trick you in their ways.
And with a wave of her hand, she disappears. And you sense that the bubble also falls.
Oh, I'm so glad I pulled that off.
Yuzaria is still technically dead, by the way. You're just holding her soul.
Yep.
I should probably do something about
this. Yeah.
All right. Let me explain. I've got her soul. We take her body. We get her soul cleansed. Put the soul back in. But we gotta hurry. We gotta get to that bunny church as fast as we can possibly move.
Okay. Counterpoint. We'll do that. But I'm taking the rug with me.
Oh my god.
I need you to carry the body, dumbass. I can't let go of her soul.
Okay.
Take the body. Someone grab the orb. Worry about that later.
Zelthana runs and swipes the orb.
Idris rolls Yuzaira up in the basket rug.
So, my son's probably also gonna want to help carrying, because, you know.
Yeah.
my son.
About this bearskin rug. Why are you taking the bearskin rug?
Especially when we have to run as fast as humanly possible.
Like, you are on with... Okay.
It will...
Carrying Yuzaria will put you on the ledge of over-encumbrance. Carrying that rug will put you over it and you'll move at half speed.
Leave the fucking bear rug.
He just spits blood on the bear rug, picks up Yuzaira, and says, Zelthana, do you want to check out that chest? Quickly.
Go, man!
Priorities!
Grabs Yuzaira and kind of gets to this point in the corridor and goes, wait, Silk, where are we going?
Oh my god! Out of here.
I thought, of all the things that we do, this is the one thing that we could do quickly.
All right, so while we're running, Pollen is going to take my bag of holding off my belt, pull it around the chest, then when it like slips back down, they'll grab the mouth, use the find familiar ability to teleport to me, and it'll be good.
So you just took the entire chest?
Yes, taking the entire chest.
All right.
And Zilk is going to take advantage of their cunning action and run dash, dash, dash.
All right. So it takes you...
Before we continue, I just want to say something out of character.
What?
The reason why I... Not Zeltana, but more the reason why me and Zoe was so conflicted on what to do is because I... was so certain that there was going to be a trick to it, because that's how storytelling works. I was so certain that Zilk was going to do something, but I was like, I don't know if Zeltana would realize that, and I was having this whole internal struggle of it would be really cool if Zeltana like stood up, but then that might fuck up the cool thing. That's why I was struggling more than like a meta reason.
Understandable.
Level. Yeah.
So I would like to picture Zilk is holding a soul and freaking moving it from out of the material realm into the material, then halfway across the city, holding an actual soul.
It's kind of cool.
You just, every once in a while, you just hear, hey, what the hell? What the hell is that? What are they doing?
Probably the whole time Zilk is running, he's whispering in Draconic into her soul, like, affirmations, like, you are loved. Your dragon cares about you. You're not the person you used to be. Like, just trying to pour as much positivity into this soul as they can to just know that Zilk did this with the purest of intentions to get their friend back.
Zeltana is gonna be like, running right next to Zilk to make sure that nobody gets anywhere fucking close. Just as basically like a security escort. Fire and swords. Everyone's intimidating.
Also, the reason Zilk asked for the dagger is Zilk realized Zilk had to ask for something in exchange to convince the hag that Zilk was making a selfish decision.
Fair enough. Okay,
and that's what I figured would be that would be, because if I just went, okay, I'll kill her for the orb, that's not something Zilk would do. Zilk is typically very selfish and very willing to take risks to preserve themselves. So I figured he had to ask for something else.
So
to convince her.
You take roughly, let's say, 3 hours to run to the Temple of the Thunder Bunny?
Yes.
Okay. Thundering Bunny.
By the way, I am in a lot of pain, but I want to keep doing sessions, so I need to go AFK for a little bit.
Okay.
And we can just say that Zilk is very magically drained from grabbing a soul mid-air.
That's fair. That's fair.
Alright,
So we'll say that once Zilk, you know, gets the soul and they start working on the soul and the body, Zilk is just gonna have to pass out from... Oh, because Zilk's not, like, an old fae. Zilk is still young. So this would be a major drain.
Well,
Zilk.
We'll also, if you can give us like 5 minutes to RP out a little bit, and then we'll all take a break, if that's all right. So you get to you get in front, you bash down the front doors, and you run inside, and one of the priests goes,
oh, yeah, I forgot I'm holding the soul. I obviously
And all that this priest sees is Idris holding the body and Zilk holding a ball, and... she goes, oh, by the tail of the ancients, is that what I think it is?
It is. We've got some serious evil that needs to be undone.
We must work quick. Please, Kevin, come down here, grab the body. And you see her gingerly reach out with her hands and cradles the Usaria's soul in between both hands and tucks it close to her chest. Alright. You relax, and we will get your friend up as soon as we can. And she just dashes into the back. like a mad dash into the back to start working on Usaria.
We did it. I got it here in time. And as you see Zil just freaking fall.
Holy to crap. Be fair, he just goes, Zilk, are you alright? And then passes the fuck out himself.
Also, Zilk has, you know, has been moving at 90 feet per 10 for 6 seconds, which is by far the fastest Zilk has ever moved in their life.
Especially with prosthetic leg.
Yeah, with leg.
I realize we're, like, not far off getting a long rest, so it's even funnier that this is happening. How much damage would Zilk theoretically take if a 300-pound dragonborn collapsed on top of his
Please hold.
No.
Please hold.
Do these things?
Oh, that definitely hits. We'll say it is that and that. Why not? 13.
Ah! Oh my god.
You lost half my health!
It's fine,
because
you're resting.
That's true.
Okay, so
unless I'm rogue, you should just heal all that back after the rest.
That's why I said it, because like, I figure at this point we're about to have a long rest, and it would be funny.
It is funny, I agree. So we get here, Zilk is huffing and puffing.
And blowing the house down?
And as Zilk is trying to catch their breath, an exhausted Idris, like, glances off their, like, their back as Idris falls over, just like, God damn it!
Okay,
No, I thought you were already unconscious on the floor at this point.
No, like, Zilk is in the process of passing out, not fully. Because Zilk has to say one thing before he, like, lets himself rest. Thank you for trusting me, Zilthana. Aerithyr came through and was, at least I think it was Aerithyr or some deity or I don't know, whatever the hell. Something powerful visited me in the form of a bird and brought me what I knew I'd need to catch the soul before it's too late.
It was your friend in the
family. Yeah, he figures it's Aerithyr.
Yeah.
But I'm really tired. I think we all need to rest well so Usaria gets put back together. And Zilka's just gonna kinda lay against a few and it's just like, sleep in peace, my friends. We can dream real dreams once again. Well, you guys can, I still can.
Alright, so...
I just wanted to say that in response to Zilk saying thank you for trusting me, Zoltana, it just gives a calm and knowing nod.
I need about 10 minutes.
Yeah, I was going to ask you how long you needed, so let's say...
I need a drink, I need to re-up on pain meds, and then I'll be back in about 10.
Alright, let's meet back up at 2:30 Eastern time.
I was going to say, you guys can adjourn without me.
No, we'll all take a break.
I mean, you were alive for all of that.
Yeah, that's true. Actually, I need to roll something.
Oh god.
What do I roll for this? All this. Pick. Usaria, can you pick. Hey, imagine that DO's late. Can you pick. Above 75%, 50 to 75%, 25 to 50%, or 0 to 25%?
Above 75.
Okay. No, why do I always do that? I always pick up two tens. Give me a single here. There you are.
I've also been, like, passively figuring out roll 20 for the Persona TTRPG.
So, Usaria?
Yes.
I rolled a 76. You remember. You remember everything.
Yay!
Congratulations.
I'm not sure if that's a yay.
Including the pain and including
ow.
what actually happened.
Oh, yeah, it's gone again.
Including
having internet issues.
Yeah. You also remember like what the thought, like what the nightmares were and what the thoughts were that were driving you to insanity.
Mm-hmm.
And also, through the night hag magic, allowing that evil to seep into you.
I'm really glad you remember, because it'd be really awkward trying to explain to you. Yeah, you kind of went a little evil because the night hag was messing around in your head, so I had to ritually kill you, and now we're resurrecting you.
But yeah, you remember literally
everything. You got these witch child bones?
I still got the child bones!
You still have the child bones.
How uncorrupted sane you is gonna react to seeing that your in your quiver are just a bunch of bones of dead children.
I would also recommend buying arrows.
Yeah. Really.
I mean, yeah.
Dio, are you back?
I do still have some fire arrows.
I'll let you know. I don't think I'm fine.
Maybe in downtime, Zilk can help Yuzaria make arrows, and they can kind of talk about the whole "Hey, sorry I killed you" thing, but I hope it's okay because I saved your soul and brought back the real you.
Yuzaria is in the ICU unit right now, intensive care. So, are we good to continue with the story?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I'm not gonna stream because it's not fucking playing ball.
Sounds about right.
Sad idea.
You guys are in the temple for 3 days. The entire time, thank you for the raid, Dio. The entire time, you do not see Yuzaria at all. The leader, who I forget the name of, comes out, talks to you a couple times about like what they're doing, and you know, gives you updates. But besides that, she's not allowed to have any visitors, anything. On the fourth day,
I take it we get a long rest. Sorry.
Yes, you get a long rest.
I missed that bit.
On day four, she comes out and goes, "Well, there's some good news. We're moving her out of our intense watching program, and she is well enough for you all to see her. Tomorrow we should be able to release her back, and she'll be out and be able to walk around. So would you like to see her?"
Absolutely.
Just imagine going, no.
Nah, we're
all right. Yeah, that's all right.
All right, well, those who want to see her can follow me. So she leads you to, back into, like, literally it looks like a hospital wing. And turns right, and you see Yuzaria with what looks like a half circle over her, with all these runes just kind of rotating around. And Yuzaria, fully conscious, fully awake, and you know, and just laying in bed underneath it, just resting comfortably.
Whoever was in here walks away, he just kind of turns around to her and goes, might not be the best point, and probably could have thought about it in the past couple of days. Is there anybody about to do a little bit of healy-healy on me that I'm still a little bit ouching from the tag stuff?
Oh, yeah, while you're in there, like, you full heal. Like, all the, you know, your maximum hit points are back, your regular hit points are back. Like...
Oh, do I also get my maximum back?
Yes, you do, yeah.
Yay!
I mean, technically, those only last, that only lasts until you die. You died.
Yeah, congratulations!
Congrats! Thank you.
I needed a minor restoration.
Greater restoration, yeah.
I needed a greater to get 2 hit points back.
Oh my god.
So it doesn't seem worth it, but you know.
Yeah, like, during, like, when you guys were originally recuperating, like, that first night, they, you know, they made sure you were going to be, like, at tip peak physical blah blah blah.
That's good of them.
Yes.
I imagine my summit followed us in here.
Yes.
Is my sum allowed to come visit?
Oh, fucking god.
Yes, my sum is allowed to come visit. And as my son walks into the room, you see his tail, like, not really wag, but kind of twitches back and forth a little bit, really rapidly. And then he like, barges past everybody and goes right to Yuzaria's bedside and lays his head on top of her, on top, like, right next to her head.
That's what I was hoping. I was hoping they'd do something cute like that.
Mm-hmm.
I love my son.
My son!
Save us!
My son!
Oh, boy.
So, are there, like, any chairs in here for, like,
oh, yeah.
To sit in?
Yeah, there are four chairs because, you know, there were four people that came in with her.
Yeah.
And Zelda also
does her patented lean on a wall in the corner of the room trick.
Fair enough.
Stoke's gonna actually sit in a chair and kind of lean forward. Like, if you, he's not hiding, visibly concerned. So, welcome back.
Hi.
I'm not sure how much you remember of everything that happened, and how you feeling?
I'm good. I remember everything. That hurt.
Yeah, sorry about that, but I think I stand by my decision. I think it was for the best to bring you back. Even forget the orb. It mattered to me having my friend back in their real self.
I thank you for actually going through with that, because I'm sure that took a lot of self-control. You know, killing someone.
It was not easy. I had to, one, kill you, and then hold your soul, grab it before the hag could. She obviously left because I tricked her successfully by making a deal, a fake deal, held up my end of the bargain, so she had to hold up her end, even if she didn't get what she wanted. So I'm imagining that probably if I assume my Feywild glimpses are gonna be not so happy for a little while, but I can live with that, because you're alive, we've got the thing we need to keep helping the people of this kingdom, and your soul's back. I don't regret anything I did, even though it's what I did will hang over me for a little bit, because that killing you, that was something I never thought I had to do, and it affected me more than I anticipated.
While you're talking, all of a sudden you hear a slight tapping on the window. As you look at the window, there's
a... Also, while we're talking, I'm just giving the dragonicorn some head scratches.
Oh, okay, anyway, yeah, I figured.
Absolutely.
Of course,
that was expected. But you notice a jet black raven, like almost too black to be an actual raven, like with tapping with its beak on the window, and has a note in its beak.
I assume
window
that...
open. Or do we have to go around?
No. It'll open.
Okay.
It's one of those jump-proof ones where you can open it about an inch and a half, but it's big enough to reach a hand through.
I'm just gonna go and do it, but get like a bit frustrated that it doesn't open far enough, and try and like open it a little bit further.
Zilka's gonna take advantage of the fact they speak animal and go, who is the note for?
And all you hear is, oh, for love of God, that doesn't work either anymore. God.
Even to say?
No. Okay, I gotta find the right button. That's it. All you hear is you. And then it drops and it flies off.
Not a friendly summons. And Zilk will go over and reach their hand under the window that Idris is trying to open more and grab the note and give it a read.
The note says, so you want to learn how to teleport? Go ask your mentor, you prick.
Yeah.
I want to point out, she said she would point you to where to start.
Yeah, I know.
And she had to hold up her bargain, end of the bargain.
Yeah. Zilk asked. Zilk had no. Doesn't really care. Zilk was asking that to further deceive her. So, but for, he'll probably mention it, just because you know he's required to from his part of the bargain. But he'll explain that it was part of a fey bargain.
Yeah.
You know what I find the funniest part? He's saying this to the party holding the note. Next time I meet with my Arthur, if she was honest, we might have her true name. That's a big deal, by the way. Y'all don't know my true name. But if she was honest, we know hers.
Yes, because night hags are always honest, and they always use very well-known characters from other video games to give you a name to call them.
Zilk is doubting that she gave him her true name. But yeah. If she did, that means Zilk can contact her whenever he needs to or wants to.
Right.
Why he would need to do that, hopefully not, but it's a thing in case we get in a future whoopsie-doopsie we're screwed scenario for further bargaining.
So, while, you know, you guys are catching up and apologizing profusely to you, Zarya, it starts getting dark outside, and once it's fully dark, a cloaked figure walks, like, it looks kind of weird because it is a fully cloaked, that hood pulled way down, figure, arms in the sleeves, walks into the room, and just kind of looks at you, Zarya, kind of contemplating, and then looks at you and goes, "You'll go this far, huh?"
Do we recognize the voice?
Yes, you do.
Is it the Queen's?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, I did what I had to do to deceive the Night Hag. I don't regret my actions, and I'm glad my friend's alive with her true soul in her body.
Wait, he gave one of the orbs to a Night Hag?
Yeah.
Oh, that's bad. Yeah. Well, we have it now. We have it now, and hopefully you are safe. Listen, I don't have much time, but I just wanted to warn you that... Oh, shit, I didn't think this far ahead. actually, I did. I need to take that back. I just want to warn you that the blue orb was given to the wizard Eludium. Find him. Find his tower. And I'm working on getting the black orb back to you. And all of a sudden, you just hear a burst of commotion in the hallway, and the Queen Simri kind of looks back behind her and is like, "Oh God, they found me!" And two guards just burst in, wielding halberds, just going, "What do you think you're doing? You're supposed to be in your room." I'm sorry, my friends. I'm sorry. I'll go back now." And before you can even react, they grab her by the arms and yank her into the hallway and out of the temple.
Well, there she goes.
Idris.
What was the name of the wizard again?
It is Eludium.
Can you spell it?
Eludium.
Oh, it's
okay, thank you.
Seeing the scuffle in front, Idris, not really knowing what's going on, just kind of turns around and just goes, "Is that how royals are normally treated?"
One second.
It's funny, actually. That caught me off guard that it was funny.
Okay, I thought my dad fell. He did not. Okay, cool. All right. So. So, anyway.
I kind of forgot we still had another orb to freaking laugh. But.
There are four.
I will say.
Over the past couple of days, we worked out what the green orb does.
Who wants to study it?
I'll do it.
Don't all speak up at once.
I mean, Idris can't do fuck all with it until someone else tells him what it is.
Right.
I don't think I wrote a note for what it is.
I did.
Good. Fill us in.
Fill it. Right.
Fill us in.
You had me make note of the name and the effects. You are welcome.
Thank you.
It is the herb, orb of earthen might. gives a plus two to con to constitution rolls. Well held. Or worn.
Yeah. That's it. Plus I remember now. Con.
Yep.
Zathanna in the corner just like starts playing with fiddling with like a tiny fireball and just like throwing it between her hands, and she looks kind of deep in thought.
I also had Pollen nab the chest that was in there. It's in our bag of holding, but I feel like I shouldn't pull that out in the middle of this recovery room. That can be a later thing when you're on your feet, but
yeah, so you guys have been there 4 days without looking in this thing.
Yes, self-control. It's probably because Zilk has it on his belt. Self-control.
That's impressive.
Yeah. Because Zilk obviously wouldn't want to go, ooh, pilfering through loot until they know Yazaria's, you know, going to be actually okay.
Right. Yeah. That
Now, Zilk would have taken a look at the dagger that they got from the pact with the hag, which, you know, it was just part of the deception. Mm-hmm. So he doesn't expect it to do anything, but he would at least take a look at it.
So roll me an arcane check.
Yeah, he probably would have used detect magic as well, so I'll just
okay.
He's had plenty of time to do that.
Okay, since you've had 4 days to do this, I'm just going to say that
I got a 21.
You know, if you were to use this, you would be cursed for all time.
Oh, wow.
This dagger just radiates evil. Basically, it is a dagger that is designed specifically to carve the soul out of a body. Purely evil. And yeah, it's one of those places, if you pick it up, you're going to end up turning into either as bad or worse than a night hag.
So Zilk is screwed for eternity.
Only if you use it.
Ah,
oh wait,
okay.
Yeah. Only like you use, I'm just gonna say that you have to use it 3 times in order to be completely cursed.
Okay.
But after 4 days, the effects of the curse have worn off on you. But you know, if you use it again, then there's probably no turning back.
Got it.
Sorry, was it green orb plus two to con or plus two to con saves?
It is plus two to con.
So that includes, that'd be con saves as well as con checks, as well as saving, what's the word?
Plus HP, plus...
Yeah, it's big plus con.
Yes, it big plus con. Oh, I actually hit average on that.
So yeah, Zilk will probably find a safe way to get rid of this dagger. Or alternatively, sell it on the black market to someone who wants to become something like this. Because there's definitely people out there who would
want to
transcend their physical form. This would do it.
Oh, I was looking on the wrong one. Oh, that's 3d6. Cool. Okay, continue. I'm just doing things in the background.
Do we want to take a look at the chest now? With how big is this room? Like, can I pull the chest out of the bag in here safely?
You can. It would be tight, though.
Okay. So, now that we have our...
fuck. Ignore that. Do not look in bag of holding right now.
I had auto-played it. I'll pretend I didn't read it. If it's alright with you guys, we do have enough room to pull out that chest now, and I wanted to wait for Yuzaria to be conscious, because I'm hoping there's something in here that she can use, because, you know... During your, let's say your trip down Madness Lane, you kind of destroyed most of your physical ammunition. So I'm hoping there's something in here.
Oh yeah. Yeah, that happened. I'm fine with it.
Don't. We might need to get rid of those bones in your bag. Is there? They're not good bones.
But what if I want to keep them?
want to kill people with the bones of children?
I mean,
sure, the priest did enough work and they fixed her properly.
It's like, well, the children were already dead.
I am proud of you. I am so proud of you.
But also, just, I feel like it would be, let's say, I am forgetting English words. Like, a reminder of what happened, so maybe next time I don't fall for insanity that easily again?
That's a good point. Hanging on to an arrow might not be the worst idea to kind of remind you of where you've been.
Yeah.
So, Zoka's gonna make sure the door is closed. He's gonna go in the bag of holding and bring out the chest. Or I guess reach into the bag of holding and bring out the chest. We should probably do this quickly before the nurses come back and see us filtering through a chest in this med room. Pull it out, pop the lock, open her up, see what we got.
Okay, who does not have a magic weapon right now?
Me?
Cool, okay.
I think.
I'm making slight adjustments.
My daggers are not magical technically, but I have the stone which makes them magical. So yes. I'm Gucci.
So you find inside of this 10 100 GP gems. So you can pick off that table whatever gems you want. Cool. 2100 gold pieces. A firebrand. An elven bow plus 3.
Fucking hell.
And a ring of regeneration.
Wow!
Damn.
I want to point out, I rolled all of that.
Wow. What is a firebrand? I'm not actually familiar with that.
Please hold, let me look it up. Because I'm not 100% sure either.
Am I gonna get even more fire plusness?
Fire.
So, a firebrand. No, that's all. Wait, is it not even listed? Okay, thank you, book, for having. Oh, that book fell on the ground. Cool. So, a firebrand is. I see. So this is a scroll of firebrand.
Gotcha.
Which works just like the spell. You throw a small shining ball of fire at a creature within range that brands it with your mark. Make a ranged spell attack against the target. On a hit, the target takes 1d6 fire damage and is branded until the end of your next turn. While it is branded, the target takes an extra 1d4 fire damage every time it takes fire damage. If you cast a spell on
mine.
A creature, if you cast a spell on a creature that is already branded, its current brand lasts until the end of your next turn, but does not gain another brand.
Wow.
Mine.
What level spell is that? I've never even heard of that one.
That is a cantrip. Conjuration cantrip.
What?
Yeah.
Damn.
I love that.
Technically, I'm trying to see who can use it, but that's not. Oh, I see. That's ignore what I just said. Ignore what I said, because that was that was from a homebrew site.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Because it's listed in the thing.
Reroll the fire, Brandon.
Oh, here we go. I'm modifying a frost brand for this. Okay, so it's attached to any sword. Or any weapon, I should say. When you hit with an attack using this magic weapon, the target takes an additional 1d6 fire damage. In addition, while you hold the sword, you have resistance to fire damage. And in hot temperatures, the blade sheds bright light in a 10-foot radius and dim light for an additional 10 feet. When you draw this weapon, you can extinguish all non-magical flames within 30 feet of you. This property can be used no more than once per hour.
Cool.
Again, mine.
I mean, I'm obviously gonna take the ball.
Do you, Trip, do you want to copy what I have and then I'll delete my post and you put yours?
What do you mean?
Well, you're the one in charge of the bag of holding, right?
Oh, yeah, I can do that.
Yeah, just copy it and then I'll delete mine. That'd be the easiest.
So, the bow is claimed and the firebrand are claimed.
Yes, there's still
those.
2100 TP.
I pulled up the Ring of Regeneration.
Uh-huh.
It doesn't seem to require attunement. So we can pass that around as needed, which is very nice. Specifically, because it could get me my leg back.
That it could.
But do I need my leg back? I feel like there would be no change if I got my leg back. I just wouldn't be using a dragon bone for a leg anymore.
And it wouldn't be as cool. Let's be honest. It wouldn't be as cool.
It wouldn't be quite as cool. Also, I personally think, because it was a magical, like, that was like a magic weapon that ripped off my leg, and they tried to heal it and did it wrong, there's a chance that it might not work for that. Because lots of magic has already been thrown at my stump unsuccessfully.
Stump. If you wear it because of how much magic they have attempted to, because if you remember, it was botched. The attachment was botched.
Yeah, they
freaked it up. It was botched so bad that you technically... You now have resistance to magic on your stump only. It doesn't give you, like, immunity to magic spells, but...
Yeah, it just means I don't get to hero my leg back.
Yeah, your leg's gone.
Yeah, it's gone.
Like, between being here and gone, yours is past gone.
Yeah. I do really think that the Ring of Regeneration is something that Dio should definitely wear.
Makes sense.
As your second ring, because 1d6 hit points every 10 minutes,
that's really good.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I will put a Ring of Regeneration in my inventory.
And then we'll just remember, if we ever need it for someone else, take it off Dio and throw it to that someone else. Which leaves 100 GP gems and 2100 gold.
Would you like me to read off what those gems are? Because I'm curious.
I'm not too hot, personally.
How do you want me to... What am I doing with the firebrand thing?
That attaches to your weapon. Think of it.
Do I need to change anything?
Oh, just that.
Could I put it on my packed weapon?
Yeah, but to get the effects, you have to use that weapon. Like when you hit with that weapon, it gives you 1d6 extra fire damage.
Okay.
So it's not for your spells.
And then I vote that since you all got awesome magic items, we used the remaining money between Maddie and myself or something for things.
I mean, Maddie got a magic glaive.
Oh. Well, and I do need to buy some arrows.
Yeah.
Other than that. So.
I don't know. Silk is content with being alive at the moment.
Same.
And Yuzaria being alive.
Trip.
Yes.
Can I request a little bit of roleplay between the two of us?
Absolutely.
Because, like, whilst you guys have been looking through the chest, Zeltana is just, like, deep in thought and not really paying attention. So do you mind, like, handing the thing to her?
Zilk will pull out the firebrand. Also, we'll close the chest, put the chest in the bag of holding. Might need that later, who knows?
Fair enough.
Gonna add a dungeon chest to the bag of holding.
Because why not?
Zilk's gonna take the firebrand. First, noticing Zeltana's playing with their fire, I'm gonna angle my cup to try and suck the fire out of your hand to, like,
get
your attention.
It's funny, though.
It is really funny, so I'm gonna do that. While you're playing with your fire, it goes into the cup, and as you look up, you see Zilk with this very cool, like, not quite a weapon sheath, but like kind of like a sword cap, like you would slide over the, to, you know, protect the handguard. But it's all fiery.
How about we make it like, you know how in Call of Duty they have those keychain things?
Oh, fuck you.
Yeah, but you know what I'm talking about though, right?
No, I do, but I'm not happy about it.
Or you can go
dangly fiery weapon chart.
Yeah.
That's cool.
I'll even let you design it.
Cool.
While they were going through the loot, this seemed like it was needed for you. If you attach it to your weapon, it'll give it that fiery Shazam you like to be throwing around. And unlike your burning AOE hands things, my cup can't eat this. So this should help us be able to fight side by side a little safer. And I'll hand it to you.
Yeah, so that reaches out and takes it.
I mean, you could also get rid of the cup, but you know.
Yeah, I'm getting closer and closer to stealing and breaking it.
The problem is I was specifically told I can't.
Yeah, it cannot be broken. By the way, Zilk, that does not count.
I can teleport far away.
Zilk!
Throw
Zilk.
The cup and then leave.
Zilk, I'm going to say that does not count towards your charges for it being used.
Okay. Since it was a flavor one, fair.
Yeah, since it was flavor.
Stilk's gonna... You hadn't seen that person in a long time, I can tell by the look in your eyes. But, I want you to know that our past doesn't have to define us. It defines us as much as we let it. And, that you're a pretty alright person. You've stood by my side even when you saw me do something terrible. You trusted me, and I appreciate that. And I was prepared for the illusion I was going to see. You were not. So if you need to talk, I'm here.
Zelthana gets a little bit angry, and she kind of steps up and says, "You do not talk about her. Have you got that?"
I understand. And then not going to say anything.
And she walks out the room because she's not happy.
Fair.
Zell, when you walk out of the room, you notice all the acolytes and all the quote-unquote nurses are huddled around one sheet of paper. Talking excitedly and like, "Oh my god, that actually happened. Yeah, I can't
believe that." I'm gonna walk up to the group. Do any of them notice that I'm there?
Yeah, one of them turns to you and go, "Have you seen this?" and hands you the piece of paper. On it says, "Notice to all citizens, Queen Simray has been arrested for treason. Temporarily taking over the kingdom is Vizier Voluth. And we will announce soon any changes in this development."
Zoltan is gonna try and snatch the piece of paper. And then
they let you. No, they let you, and they're just all talking like, "Oh my god, is this a coup? Is, like, what's going to happen here? This has never happened. Like, why would she? We're peaceful. Why would she betray the kingdom?"
Whilst they're talking, Zelthana just kind of hurries back to the room with everyone in, and passes the piece of paper to Zilk.
Okay.
"Well, I'll be. Queen arrested. The vizier's in charge for now. Well, he was always kind of in charge, but this is bad news. This kind of puts us on a clock. Especially if they intend to execute her for treason. Do I notice any markings in Thieves' Cant anywhere on here?"
Nah.
Okay.
It looks like it It came from a mass printing press, is
okay, cool.
Pretty much what it is.
So, gives us a timetable. Well, not necessarily a timetable, more like a ticking clock. To get that blue orb and that black orb. Or alternatively, get the blue orb, free the queen, then try and confront him with 3 out of 4 and take the 4th and the 5. We got trouble, basically. We ain't out of the woods yet.
Future trouble.
I think we need to keep an eye on this as this develops. I'll think of some way how we do that while we're looking for wizardy do. But,
So Idris is kind of like going, knows he knows nothing about any wizards, so looks to the people in the group that he thinks might have a better idea and kind of says, do anybody have any idea where he might be?
Zoltana, I'm sorry. While everybody's kind of talking about this, can you roll a history check?
I will indeed.
Yes. Well done. Well done. That is a nat one. Thank you for participating.
It's not a nat one.
Oh, it's not three. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I read that wrong. It said history one. I thought that was one. I'm sorry. So the only thing that you kind of realize is it's very suspicious that last night Simray visited, and this morning, all of these flyers are out everywhere. It's very suspicious. The sus level has gone up.
Sussy baka.
No.
Myself. Okay. Zaltan is gonna speak up a little bit and say, we saw her yesterday. And these flies are already out.
History check for all!
Woo! For all a good history check.
Please, run my dice.
Well done, Trip.
Six.
Oh my
six.
God.
For fuck's sake.
Idris knows the most about history.
What'd you roll? Idris, what'd you roll?
I got an 8. A 19.
I got an 8.
You know what? All of a sudden you feel like this random feeling of time rewinding a little bit. And
wait, no. We all still have loads of inspiration.
That's true. Oh, you do. You should probably use it.
I'm using my inspiration.
Can I do one of mine too?
You can, yeah. Yeah, you absolutely can.
16.
Okay.
Right, here we go. 9.
Nine. Okay. So, Zell, you kind of, like, go, your suspicion deepens. Idris, with the 16, you, on the other hand, are like, if, like, this isn't natural. Like, normally, if even a noble is arrested, it's at least a week until the commoners know. But the fact that these were already out so quick, like, it doesn't sit right.
So, wait, if we saw her yesterday and now she's been... Doesn't it normally take ages for them to, like, let us know that things have changed? Why is this being done so quickly?
Maybe it was staged, pre-planned. Gave her the info.
Sorry. I'm being an asshole.
Yzaria.
We're just your god guy.
Subtlety.
Yzaria has been in this ward long enough that maybe they specifically fed the queen the information, knowing she'd come here to get that kind of public arrest and then immediately do this. Governments are not efficient, even where I'm from. So this is too fast.
You just
I
hear
agree.
Like an ethereal voice from the heavens go, ooh.
Ooh.
So we gotta move quickly.
It sounds like we're entering the big baddies end game. this vizier is endgame. It sounds like he's got all the pieces on the board where he wants them. I think it's about time we pick up the pace and make sure we're on that board.
Okay. So
that was a terrible analogy. Sorry.
We need to go and get these orbs, yes?
Yeah.
Where do we find the information about this Illudin?
Illudin.
Can I ask, have any of us heard that name before?
History checks.
Come on. 12! Better! I'm improving!
19.
I got fine.
What'd you get, Dio?
I'm not from here.
What'd you get, Dio?
19.
Okay, for all those who got 19, you know that there's a place.
Why does he just know so much about history?
I don't know! I mean, ask yourself this. Why do I know so much about history? Anyway, you know that there were stories of a place on the edge of the Arid Desert, roughly, we'll say, right about here, where, like, an entire area just cannot be walked on. Like, you don't know why, but it's just, this area is not accessible. Like, there's no signs or anything, but people are just prone to just steer clear of this area. And you kind of figure out that only a powerful wizard. Only a powerful wizard. God! Only a powerful wizard would be able to pull this off.
I think I heard something a while ago. Something about like the Arid Desert and magic-y stuff going on, maybe.
Yeah, and
sky.
People just steering clear, like north side, northeast corner of the Arid Desert.
North side.
Why'd it have to be a desert?
I would.
Because yeah. God doesn't want to be in my natural territory.
Because God wants
so
to go
other places. Roughly X amount of time, X amount of days travel, but we should get there. Do we want to go on horses or do we want to walk?
It is 5 days
I have a dragon.
Walking. Is five actually it's 5 days on horseback, 10 days walking.
I have an out of character question. Do any of us even have proficiency in riding mounts?
No!
Probably not.
Nobody took that.
I don't get it until later.
From I have Druid, animal handling.
Yeah, I've got animal handling as well, but
I'm proficient at animal handling.
One of the things you can take though is because travel from Treelum to Plabble down there in the Arid Desert is pretty common. There are actual, like, not convoys, but, like, you can charter certain, like, what are they called? Carriages? To take you there?
If you want to be spicy, we can use Feywild gigs. But I don't know if I want to be spicy, because I feel like we'll lose a party member in the Feywild.
There's a good chance.
Especially now that there's a hag who hates us.
Yes.
Who can't attack us on this plane, but could if we went there. I rescind that suggestion.
It's not that scary anymore. We have had our first player character death on episode 6.
No, right, but the hag, part of the hag's deal was she wouldn't attack us here. She'd leave the kingdom. So if we go into the Feywild, she can then attack us without breaking her deal.
Not going to the Feywild.
And guess who is constantly going to be monitoring who comes and goes from the Feywild?
Yeah.
We'll it's fine. We'll go there. We'll forget about her and she'll pop up and we'll be like,
"Oh, that's interesting."
Maybe it would. I don't know if going for the wizard first before trying to rescue the queen is the best play, considering the amount of time we're going to have to commit to it.
Right. I personally
I am interested in getting the queen out of Valuth's hands. Because, let's just say I'm not super willing to put another innocent life between us and our goal. And if they already have her marked as a traitor this fast, they could arrange an execution very quickly.
Okay, so we go break into the castle, get her out, and then do what? Where do we put her where she's safe?
Keep her with us. Take she's with very clearly competent. If she manages to keep getting away from her royal guards.
Okay, so, but again, break into the castle, prison, wherever she's being held, but we don't know where she is. Possibly kill some people, get out, hide again.
Definitely no. Kill some people.
I'm more suggesting that, especially if we intend to usurp who is now at the throne, I kind of feel like we need the previous monarch with us for that.
Okay.
I don't know. We could try and make a quick play for the orb, then try and break her out of prison and make it a 2-for-1, heist the orb, heist her. But that seems risky.
Idris.
Speaking of orb.
Idris.
Oh, yep.
Idris.
Idris.
Hello,
God, I can hear you. I'm in the Bunny Temple.
Why don't you, just for your shits and giggles, why don't you do a... we'll do another history check. But, with advantage...
I swear to fucking God.
With advantage.
Oh, thank fuck. Yeah, okay. Not great, but...
And you're going into your knowledge of how, like, the underground works on this.
Okay. I don't know if that gives me anything.
No, it doesn't.
I have.
It doesn't.
Okay, cool. I'm glad you gave me advantage because...
Because you're rolling that one. I know.
No, it was a 2.
Oh, well. At least bad things didn't happen.
Plus 0. I got an 11.
You realize that this would actually be a really good time to go into the castle, because during coups, or like, you know, during, like, if the queen's arrested, there is a lot of turmoil inside the castle. You might not be able to see it on the outside, but thieves are definitely sneaking in to get at the treasure while there's so much commotion going on.
Also, you might, this is out of character, realizing something Idris might realize. Also, you probably have guards and stuff who are split between which monarch to support.
There you go.
So, might not involve a ton of bloodbath.
Bloodbath.
Actually, I feel like Zilk is smart enough to say that, so I'll have him say that.
Okay, so... we... now... is... probably a good time. I agree with Zilk. Now is good. We should... there's a lot going on. Guards are probably not sure of their allegiances yet. Some are probably very in the back pocket of Valuth. Some are still probably going, yay, Queen Simre. So,
yas, Queen.
We yas, can probably queen. Not kill those ones. And they might help us. Plus, the thieves will be going in a lot. So, maybe... Zilk and I can go and find some people in the place I didn't really want to go and see who might be able to help us get into the castle a bit easier if that's something we think we should do.
Also, I was, spoiler alert, I wasn't going to tell you all this, but since it's relevant, I was planning on meeting with the local underground tomorrow, or soon, because I have something for them.
Ow.
And now seems as good a time as any to connect with the local underground, see how they feel about the whole monarchy situation.
Okay, so, like I said previously when we had our heart-to-heart in the tavern, That the brand I have on my arm, if you see it, the underground is near, and we can go speak to them.
Yeah, our buddy, the general shopkeep, Apu, told me who the local contact is for the underground. For the black market, at least.
Okay. Did he tell you where they were?
Yeah.
It's not 10 Dwarf Street, is it?
I'll be honest, I remember where it was. I don't remember the name of where it was. It was the magic shop that we went to and got where Zell got his armor from.
Magic Mart.
Magic Mart.
Okay, so
there is a shop under that shop that is run by the local the local crime peeps. Okay. Probably the local crime lords. It's like their primary black market hub for this area.
So, to the magic shop?
You wanna... I was kinda... Zilk seems hesitant. I don't wanna split us up when one of ours is recovering, but...
Yeah, she's fine, let's go.
Wow!
She's had 4 days, it's fine.
I mean, she did just have... She had her soul pulled out of her body. Decorrupted and then put back in.
It was a roller coaster.
Nobody... Out of character, I don't really want to split the party and then, what's Yuz gonna do while we're meeting with the underground? Like, what's Turtle gonna do while we're there, you know?
So, just so you know...
Hold up.
God needs to go to the potty really quick, so keep talking amongst yourselves.
Okay. I most logical decision would be to split the party. However, we've done most of our party splitting in the in-between bits. Between sessions.
Okay.
And Zelthana and Usaria, they could just get stabbed. Going in.
I mean, I'm used to being stabbed now, so let's go.
Ooh.
I mean, all things considered, you've probably been stabbed the least. You just got stabbed the most lethally.
Yeah.
Zelthana has definitely been stabbed a lot. She's 120.
Yeah.
I was like, holy shit.
Being stabbed the most because the kobolds that stabbed him in that first dungeon.
Yeah.
How old is Idris?
29. No, wait, I put it down. 23.
Yeah, Zelthana's almost 100 years older than you. She's definitely been stabbed more.
I don't know. Has Zelthana frequented knife fights for the last 100 years?
God is bad.
Kinda.
Cool.
Why are we arguing over who's been stabbed
the most? It's a really funny thing that our party would totally be like, nah, I think I've been stabbed more. No, I've been stabbed more. That's a very us thing to do. Zelthana definitely has not been stabbed the most.
I've died, so shut the fuck.
Yeah. Slight sidetrack. Who would benefit from a +2 to con the most?
Probably you.
Probably Tanks.
Yeah. Also, your storm aura is a con thing.
Thanks.
No, it's a con for your DC.
No, it's
Yeah, it is.
8 plus dex plus proficiency.
For the saving throw?
Yeah, that's what...
Oh, I thought it was con.
8 plus my dex plus proficiency.
Oh, gotcha. But do you benefit from con, because you're unarmored, it comes from con.
Yes.
So that would give you more AC.
But is it...
Also, tank.
Also, yeah, tank.
Yeah.
So is it +2, so it would give me a... Put me to 20, or is it... The +2, so it's technically +4, so it would put me at 22 constitution to give me that +2 to a roll.
It is up to your constitution score.
Which one? The big or the small one?
The big one. So basically, what this does is it modifies your con roll up an additional 2 points. So you would get a +2... let's say that you had a con of 22, of 20, it's now 22.
Yeah.
Okay, so con of 18, it would put me to con 20.
Correct.
Yes. Yep.
Okay. So I will work out how to...
Yeah, it'll also give you a frick ton of hit points, because HP bonuses from con are retroactive. So if you increase your con, you get the HP that you would have at every previous level at that con level.
Yes.
I will, between sessions, think of how to jewelry-fy the...
Yeah. Zilks is held in the jaws of an animal skull on a necklace around his neck. That's who he holds the yellow one.
And I will work out how to itemify the orb of
Earthen Might.
The Grorb!
The Grorb.
So, Yuzaria can't leave the hospital yet, or are we taking Yuzaria with us?
Yuzaria is cleared to leave. She has her discharge. Yay! She has her discharge paperwork. It is early afternoon, though. By the time they tell you at like 9 o'clock in the morning, but you don't get out until like 5 p.m.
I know.
Yeah, so it's getting late in the day. As you walk out of the temple, and start getting towards more civilized areas, some would say, you start seeing like people walking around. Some are walking around in a haze. Some are walking around looking panicked. Some of the guards like look very nervous, and other guards look very confident. Have fun with that.
I love that.
All of a sudden, you see. All of a sudden, you see somebody walk over with a piece of paper, to the notice board, and you see him just like pound a nail into the top of it, and a bunch of people like circle around it.
I'd like to. Oh, I forgot I'm tall. I can just look over their heads and see what it says.
Sure. would you like to know more? As they say in Starship Troopers. You see on the paper, it has a picture of Queen Simre with bars in front of her. And it says, Trial of the Century, Queen Simre versus the Realm. Charges treason.
She's getting a trial.
The trial starts tomorrow at 8 a.m.
That's kind of convenient, because during the trial she won't be behind bars.
Yeah, but that was also would be the time where there would be the most guards, is during a trial, especially the vizier's present.
But what if we are guards?
That is definitely a potential idea. Try and join the people guarding her at the trial, break her out during the trial. That also would be very public, draw a lot of attention.
Yeah.
A lot of things to consider. I'm not against the idea. A lot of things to consider. I'll make note of the time so we... There's no... I was going to say keep an eye on the clock, but there's no clock to keep an eye on.
No, there's always a clock in the corner of the screen.
I'll go back to the party though, and I'll tell them what I saw if they didn't push up with me at the bulletin board.
Okay.
So, I guess it's... You sure about this? You sure we all want to meet with the black market here? See about finding some criminal aid?
I think it's the best call. They should, and kind of rubs his arm where his brand is, despite everything, should be able to help us to get in a lot easier than it would be beforehand.
Especially if we can frame it as to their benefit.
we break in, go after the high profile prisoner, gives them the opportunity to go for the, you know, the vaults, big gold, jewels, whatever the hell. Try and frame it as a mutual gain kind of arrangement. Zil kind of cracks his neck and he's like, all right, I'll be up. By the way, I have not contacted this black market before, so I don't know what they'll do to... I don't know what they'll do. So, fingers crossed, I guess. As I'll walk in the direction of the magic shop.
Idris follows Silk.
Alright, so...
Hyra follows Idris.
And God so follows everyone.
Starts dissociating.
I will say, I don't know how much longer I can go.
Yeah.
Me neither.
I gotcha. Okay, so you go to the magic shop, Magic Mart, a subsidy of Walmart, of course, and you walk in, and the proprietor will say, Sammy W. Nobody's gonna get that reference. Is behind the counter and goes, oh, welcome. What can I get you today?
So this isn't the same L from last time. It's a different
one. No. This is, you see on his, he's dressed in like much, much nicer robes than everybody else who's working there. His name tag is shinier. You know, he's corporate.
Well, hi there, first of all.
Hello.
I'm trying to remember how, like, so, let me remind myself how Thieves Can works. I think I can use it silently. Let me remind myself.
Sure, we'll say yes.
Yeah.
Why not?
Zilk is kind of talking with his hands while he's talking to the clerk. We were here previously. I was recommended here by a boo. For a certain kind of magical item exchange sort of deal.
A magic item exchange, huh? Well, what are we talking about? Is it something extremely rare that you don't want to, like, you know, have other people see?
It's something that I would rather not be sold in the storefront.
Oh, one of those. Okay. And he kind of leans in and you feel a double tap on your elbow. So is this a large item or, you know, so I know which part of the room that we need to go to?
Small in size, large in value.
Okay. You feel another double tap on your elbow and, Idris, you know that this is how the, what do we call them? Trinity? No.
Yes.
You see it happen. You know this is how Trinity kind of says, are you or are you not? Part.
Idris kind of, standing next to Zilk already, repeats the gesture.
Okay, and he glances over to you and then up to your eyes and just nods and says, all right, well, come on back. And he leads you through, like, those, you know, those double doors that swing both ways? Leads you through that set of those through the stock room where you see just brilliant magic items. Stuff that you know would never hit the floor. It's private buyers. And then even deeper.
Impulse to suppressing Zilk's impulse to sleight of hand.
Yeah, good idea. And then he leads you down a set of stairs where it's dingy, but not dingy, if that makes sense, right? And it's kind of cozy in a certain way. And you see him walk up to a door with just a glass window in it, knocks on it. Face comes out, really, like, big, tough guy. And he nods, the face nods, and then the door opens. You guys go through, and you are surrounded by merchandise of all types. Not only magical, but, like, you see arrows in the corner. You see magical gems. You see items. You see, hell, you even see knockoff orbs. So, what are we talking?
Well, I have a deal. I have an item that I would like to sell, but also, we need to get in touch with someone. Zilk's gonna look to Idris and let Idris do this one. Because Zilk doesn't know the specifics of Idris's connections to the Trinity.
Idris is feeling a bit uncomfortable. So is just kind of holding his shoulder. We're also here for some information and maybe some help. We need to get somewhere, and I feel it might be mutually beneficial, as it might assist you to
you see him
put a little more in the coffers, as it were.
You see him shake his head and just go, "Will you stop trying to hide this shit? I am so tired of this. What do you want?"
Look, we need to get into the castle.
Okay. You could have just said that. Who's going to listen here? Come on. You don't... you're Trinity, right?
Habit.
Are you Trinity?
Habit.
Are you Trinity or aren't you?
And Idris just, like, rips his fucking, like, shirt off his shoulder to show the brand.
He looks at it and goes, "That's Skibble Branch, right?"
Yeah, but... Is there anyone around from there?
They don't come in much, only with the monthly shipment. But you said you wanted in the castle.
Yeah.
Oh boy. There are a couple operations going on in the castle right now. I'll tell you that for free. The rest, I mean, I can't give it away for free. Come on, you know this.
Yeah. We don't know where we need to get in the castle yet.
Okay.
Probably dungeons, but knowing...
Wait. Hold on. You're looking for the queen, aren't you?
Yeah.
I'll take that as a yes.
Yeah, we're doing some work for her. And I know you're all smart guys, but, and I'm sure you've fucking worked it out by now. This whole thing going on right now, it's not right. She's being set up, and Valuth is a bad guy. You know that, right?
Oh, yeah.
And I'd like to clarify, not us kind of bad guy, like murder children, tire demon, well, fey demon, that kind of bad guy.
So he kind of looks around Yuzaria to Yuzaria's back and quiver and goes, "Looks like you kill children too."
Okay. Just a reminder of things that went wrong.
How bad did they go?
I had to pull a soul out of someone's chest. That bad of a guy.
What the hell, man?
It also means that we shouldn't, you know, just let's maybe not take this can we take this conversation out of the middle of the showroom floor?
Come into my office. So he opens up the door. And
Zilk is just gonna kind of flick Idris and be like, "You gotta keep your voice down, man."
As you walk past, you notice some whispers starting to happen from a couple of the workers there, and you hear one of them go, "Badass." And then he opens up the door, and it's a richly carpeted office. It has a beautiful desk, beautiful chair. There are two chairs in front of his desk. He ushers everybody in and closes the door and just goes in front of everybody, leans up against the desk and goes, "All right, so explain this."
So you might have to fill in some details because, you know, my memory's not the best. But
I got you.
We met Queen Simre while Maddie was out doing something by a portal. She told us roughly that Valuth was trying to do something. We've got to get these orbs and just kind of gently, quickly flashes it and tucks it away quite quickly. Keeping his hand on it so it doesn't get lost, obviously. But we need to get these. Valuth has one. We also need to get that one with her. But Simray needs to be restored to the crown. She needs the crown back.
Let me ask you a question. What's your name?
I've been told not to tell people my name.
You can share your alias, because I assume you have one.
Just give me a name to call you. What should I call you? I'm going to call you Fred. Can I call you Fred? Cool, I'm going to call you Fred. Fred, do you remember when you were kind of, oh, thank you, Turtle. When you became part of the guild, right? Do you remember what we told you about stability at all? History check. With advantage, because it's... You're talking about your forte here. Thank you, Turtle. And you remember back, and one of the biggest sayings that you had in school was, stability means profit. So you remember that, right? You remember what we told everybody when they first joined, right?
Yes, stability is profit.
And
this is not good for profit right now.
This is horrible for profit. Like, Valuth was the one that was trying to shut us down last month. Like, you know, he comes down here. Okay, and this is through the grapevine. I wasn't a part of this, Fred. Can I still call you Fred? Fred, we were, I wasn't a part of this. But through the grapevine, I heard that he tried to actually contract some of our people to work as guards. And I know some people took it, others didn't. You know how it is. But yeah, it was just so weird to be like, yeah, this is what's happening and blah, blah, blah. But the problem I have with it, the entire problem I have with it, is Simray let us do our thing. There was a power sharing thing, right? You can't have peace without chaos. We were the chaos, we made the profit. And Simray didn't care. We want to take Valuth down, is what we want to do.
Okay, so we're working together on this one. Like I said, we need to get in, get her out, and he has an orb, baseball-sized black. We need that too.
It lets him temporarily see into the future somehow through divination magic. So if we remove that from play, all of y'all will be able to operate without... I assume you guys have been having problems with the guards, especially lately when your deal with him broke off, because he could literally use this orb, focus it on you, and odds are, predict what you're gonna do.
Is that how he knew what we were doing?
We're not sure of the limitations of this divination orb yet, but we know he's been abusing it to take advantage of not just us, but to get him to this rise in power. That's how we think he was able to arrange the trial and all that so quickly, is he can divine more than he should be able to.
Okay. We kind of have a plan that we've been trying to pull off for years. And I think it's perfect to try to bring that plan back now. And he goes to the door and he pulls open the door and just goes, Steve, the plan. So basically you see Steve come walking in. He's this really short, like classic nerdy looking guy. Like his glasses keep falling down. He pushes them up with one finger, you know, in between the lenses. He's just holding all these maps and everything, occasionally dropping one, having to pick it up, and then dropping other ones. He finally gets in the door, and this guy you've been talking, Sammy, goes, all right, pull out a map, 3C. So he pulls out map 3C, and 1 second while I do a quick thingy here. What?
No, how dare you do a quick thingy?
Does that reveal access? Why are you not allowed to?
I think the quick thingy has broken.
No. Yes. Maybe. Is it really because
I think
by
doing the quick
thingy. I got it. I wasn't clicking on the actual map, that's why. First off, shout out to Sheeran Cove for this map, because it is brilliant and I love it. Where are you, players? There you go.
Ah!
You alright?
You will have to zoom majorly out for this.
Oh, damn! That's so cool!
Yo!
What? That's fucking cool!
It's amazing, isn't it? I love it.
That is intricate as hell. I love it.
Like I said, thank you so much, Sheeran Co., for making this free. I found it on their actual Twitter. So thank you very much for allowing us to use this. So he pulls out this map and lays it out. He goes, okay. We have to go over a couple of things with this really quick. So there are five entrances in. One is up here. Why can't I ping? Stop it. One is up here. Why am I doing this? Oh, it's so small. One is up here. One is down here. And then, of course, we have the main entrance over here. And then there is a entrance here. And an entrance over here.
I missed that pig. Where was that last one?
To the left. Yeah, around there.
Okay.
So we need... Those are our entranceways. We have looked this entire time. We have been looking for hidden secret entrances. The closest we got was this one really weird house. I think it was at like... Steve, what was the name of that street? Dwarf Street, sir! Yeah, Dwarf Street. That's what it was.
So, funny thing.
Oh?
That one's probably not accessible anymore.
Why, actually?
Accidentally gone through that one. It comes out in a bush.
Yeah, well, I also wanted to point out that, like, that one doesn't go into the castle itself. It just literally leads to the entrance.
Into the courtyard.
Yeah, into the top left there. It's not in. So
I thought you described it in, like, the courtyard somewhere.
No, I described it as a path leading into the actual castle.
Okay.
Just a back entrance. So that's the closest we've gotten. What our plan is we've been kind of waiting for the perfect opportunity for a lot of commotion at the castle. We don't have the resources and men to actually, you know, cause such a kerfuffle, if you will. But with this, with everything going on, there are going to be a lot of people coming and going from that castle, especially the day of the trial tomorrow. And I'm sure they're setting up for it already. So if we come in the main entrance, all the way on the right here, which really is confusing because my mouse is not centered on where it is on the map and the thing. But anyway, if we come in there with the crowds, we can actually sneak. If you look really closely on the right-hand side of this map, we can use that distraction to actually sneak along this gantry right here. If we sneak around there, we can hit up these stairs, which lead us out here. And that is going to be our inn, because the inn is going to be these stairs here. All right, that'll lead us to the courtyard. Now, there's two phases to this plan for your side of the plan, okay? The first is the queen. The queen is in the dungeon, which is located on the left-hand side of the map. Right there. That is the main dungeon area from what we've been able to identify. The orb, thank you. The orb most likely will be in his chambers. So we're going to look for that top of the map right about there. If it's that important, that's where he would keep it. The third part of the plan, which you don't have to be involved in, is the rest of us are going after the vault. Okay? So once we get in, we're going to break into three teams. All right. Team one will comprise of you four members. Okay.
There's five
actually,
of us.
Will contain three of your members of five. Okay. Those three are going after Simray. The other two of you and myself will head up and get the orb. The rest of the crew is going to head into the cellar, which is located... Where's a good place for the cellar to be? Which is located up here. We're going to break off and head there. And that is going to allow us to grab what's in the actual safes and get all that gold out, okay? Now, the one thing I want to say, we are helping you so we get everything from the vault. Alright?
Dad, you see the cogs try and start turning in Idris's head?
and he's unsure what to answer, so he kind of looks at Zilk and kind of goes,
Given we're not devoting manpower to the raiding of the vaults, that's understandable.
Okay.
The risk and possible reward will ultimately fall on y'all for the vault, so that makes sense.
So, if we get caught, the backup plan is run like hell, come back to the back entrance to Magic Mart. Don't use the front entrance, go in the alleyway in the back. And just knock, just like that. And we'll get you in, we'll get you to safety, we'll go underground. If it works, you can come back here and rest and recuperate if you want to. If not, you can go, you know, straight into the wind. It is up to you.
I got a couple questions.
Okay.
Pretty quick, I'll try and make a rapid fire. It seems y'all are still kind of in the putting the pieces together phase, so I thought I'd throw some ideas at you.
Okay.
Do you have any people on the inside already? Do you have any guards, cleaners, things like that? All right.
Yes, the guard that we have on retainer is actually going to be guarding the entryway here. That is going to allow us to slip into that stairwell.
All right, good. We have one within our ranks who can take the form of a guard if we kill one. So that gives us two.
Mm-hmm.
Out of character, that's whoever is using the hat of disguising at the moment, because mm-hmm. that lets you infinitely cast disguise self on yourself.
Yep.
So that gives us two, which... Do you know when his shift changes? When your guard has... Does he shift change towards either the other wings that we're having to hit?
No. Basically, it's every guard is going to be on duty. However, they are going to be concentrated in this front section because... right here is where the actual trial is going to take place. So that's where all of most 99.9% of the guards are. Past this wall here into the courtyard is pretty much going to be undefended.
All right, gotcha.
They're just
trying to figure out in my head possible ways of getting Simray from her cell to the exit, because that's a lot of ground to cover.
I would honestly take easiest entrance, which would be you'll have two guards to deal with. Yes, you'll have two guards to deal with at this entrance to get her out. So both the orb and Simray can go through there. Two guards will guard that. You might find our reports say that there will be three guards stationed inside the actual cell as well. That's what our reports are saying.
You see, Zilk counting on his fingers and like pointing at his knives. He's like, 1, 2, 3, 4.
And honestly, at the same time, we've been trying to figure out what guard, since this has been happening so long, we don't have a proper report on this yet. But we've been trying to figure out which guards are actually going to follow Simray, which ones are going to follow Volu. So there is a chance that if you encounter these guards, they will back your move. But there's also a chance that they won't. So that's up to you to deal with. The way we're going to handle them is we're going to knock them out. We're not going to kill. That way they can make that decision later. That's what we're going to be doing in the vault. And I would urge those going after the orb. We can do everybody together for Simray and the orb, or we can do the teams. But it's up to you. I would prefer, honestly, if we stick together so that everything goes smoother and, you know, won't be as bulky. So
if we break out Simray from here, that same team could make it to the orb. Because I assume once Simray leaves her cell, guards will be notified and start heading in that direction from the north backwards back to the south, which would, theoretically, we could pull guards from the orb towards us, encounter them in stride on our way to the orb and use the orb's pickup. Splitting the teams does not work out.
We would personally like to keep it so that you either knock all the guards out before they see you so no alarms are raised. That is the preferred method.
Oh, yeah, that's obviously preferred. Yes. That's how I work. However,
if the alarm is raised, the first place they're going is the cellar.
All right.
And the reason they're going to the cellar first is because that's where all their gold is. they might do slight reinforcements to the actual jail, to the dungeon. I doubt it. The one thing we are sure of is Simray will not be moved for this trial. This is nothing but a show trial. She will be found guilty, and she will hang.
Okay, so we gotta do this quick.
Also, yes. Out of character, I am so grateful that specifically they have rules that let characters using melee weapons choose lethal or non-lethal strikes.
Mm-hmm. What's the fun in not doing that?
I'm so glad that's a thing. Old versions of D&D did not have that as an option. They were lethal and non-lethal weapon types, which was boring.
Yeah.
It means I can do things like throw my dagger, kill it forward, and hit him in the head with the blood of the dagger really hard.
So do we have any questions on this plan? Any more questions? I hear none. Okay.
I have one more.
Sure.
It's a bit of a... I hope it's a relevant question. So, best case scenario, we get in, we get out, we get it done.
Mm-hmm.
What way would we be able to take advantage of your guys' routes to get her out of the city?
Yes, we would. We will put somebody, if you remember the bush that you came out of in the dwarf house, then we will put somebody there hiding inside that entrance, and we will use our routes to get her to safety out, or you can put a cloak over her and send her into the send her back to us here, and we can keep her safe here.
Alright, thank you.
So, it's up to you. Now, honestly, I would prefer if you kept her in a safe place and not, you know, traveled with her, because more chance of being spotted.
Agreed.
But again, we can also have that person meet you there, and then, you know, you can go off with the orb and gallivant wherever you want, and then we'll take her back to...
Yeah, I would prefer to keep her somewhere safe.
Okay. So, put a man there.
I mentioned that earlier as a possibility, bringing her with us, just because I wasn't sure how down the clock criminals would be with helping us at all.
Well, the criminals... She is a means to an end, because if there's no stability, and this works in real life, if there's no stability in place, then there's no profit in it.
Right. It's kind of like the whole, how the rogues, it's how Flash comics are built, is like the rogues specifically follow a set of rules, so that way the Flashes just don't straight up kill them.
Yeah.
And so that way they can have, you know, balance. You gotta have some amount of stability in order to make money.
Exactly. All right, any other questions?
I have one that's unrelated.
Let's wrap this up, then I'll answer that. We'll meet here tomorrow. It's about maybe 10 minutes to the castle. We'll meet tomorrow at, let's say, 6 o'clock, 6 a.m.
Okay.
Come in the back door, do that knock, and we will go. We'll do our plan from there, and... Be inconspicuous, looks at Idris, especially tall people.
I will get Zilk
I can shrink
to help me. I will get Zilk to help me find a cloak.
Good. Alright, what was your other question now that we have our plan?
I was being honest when I said I do have something that I need off my hands quickly.
Okay.
And Zilk's gonna pull out the soul cutter knife.
Ooh.
What were you doing
with a night hag?
Saving the realm.
You know, it's going to be hard to find somebody to buy this. You know that, right?
Oh, I know.
Like, horribly awful.
I was also
awful.
Thinking. Yeah.
You're also but, thinking?
Also thinking, is there a chance that it can get the curse part removed? And it's just a dagger that cuts out souls. Because I know it's cursed all hail.
No, the problem with Night Hag daggers is that while they don't specifically build them, right? They don't make them. Whatever dagger they use it so much that the curse is ingrained. So there's no actual removing of this curse. The Night Hag that had this one, I don't know how he got it from her, but apparently this one was very powerful because I can feel the evil off of it standing here, not touching it.
Yeah, no, she was bad news.
So I'll tell you what. I'll put this on commission. I think, honestly, or best offer would be best here.
All right.
Because this is going to a very... It might take a while to sell, but this is going to very specific clientele. And yeah, it's normally the people we don't deal with, because we have a rule, and Fred up there knows this. He knows that we may be, you know, criminals, as some label us, but we avoid evil as much as possible in our pursuit of riches.
I'd also be willing to, as much as I'd like to make a penny off it, I'd be willing to find someone who could, you know, destroy it as well. As much as I'd like to make profit, if the best I can do is some money and it being destroyed, I can live with that too.
Yeah, I can look into that as well for you. I'll tell you which one we find first. It'll be a couple of days, but because, you know, this is going on.
Yeah.
But, whoever I find first, I'll tell you what they're charging, or I'll tell you how much they're buying it for.
Alright. I am going to hand this off to you, though.
You see him just kind of hold up his hands and say, set on the table.
Yeah. I was planning on putting it, he's gonna, like, kind of stab it in the table a little bit. Like, in the corner. So you can, like, remove it without having to, like, grab it by the blade.
Yeah, so... You stab it into the corner a little bit. He moves the corner of the map, so the map's not actually stabbed. And yeah, you see him reach and grab what looks like a leather glove, and pulls it out and is holding it. And he looks at you and goes, "You might want to get one of these at some point." And points to the glove and goes, "This repels black magic. It's great.
Very useful."
So he goes over and opens up a drawer and gently sets it in, closes it, takes the glove off. All right, so I will see everybody back.
With the dagger off Soap's person, you see him, like, take a nice big deep breath, like, oh, thank God.
Fair enough.
Because I imagine him being, you know, Fae, having, like, that radiating evil Fae object on his person for multiple days probably has made him feel not so great.
Yeah. So... And he turns around and goes, "All right, get some rest, get you what you need. We'll meet back here 6 a.m. tomorrow."
He just kind of speaks up at this point and goes, "How about we leave you something to help you prepare? And kindly ask Zilk, the container of everything for 100 gold, to give to help the raiding party, as it were."
Good call.
Why did you take an entire treasure chest? Like, normally you take what's in the treasure chest.
The treasure chest is for later use.
Okay.
Basically, just to help them get better equipped and everything with everything going on, we just want to throw 100 gold at them to help them.
Oh, okay, I see what you're doing. So the chest and the 100 gold.
No,
I didn't say anything about the chest. Just
no, the chest is in the bag of holding. We're not giving it to them from the bag of holding.
We're just giving them 100 gold, which I presume is in the bag of holding.
Yeah. I'm going to remove the imperfect dragon scales because we use those on my current armor.
Oh, yeah. He looks at the gold and he goes, "All right, I appreciate it. Just to let you know, we are doing a little bit better than that, but, you know, I'm not going to look down free gold." So he takes the gold, puts it in his pocket. Okay. I mean, it is very common for those in different sects of Trinity to actually, like, give a little token of gratitude for allowing them into their house. So,
yeah,
we'll just roll with that. Yeah. All right, go get rest. Go get kitted. We have some work to do here. I will talk to you tomorrow.
All right. I assume this is where we're calling session?
And this is where we're calling session.
Thank goodness, I am in so much pain. After this, I'm gonna take... I can't take meds for another 4 hours, so I'm gonna try and get a nice hot shower to bring my
swelling
down. A nice good shower to get my swelling down. Session was great, I loved it.
Yeah, it was
good fun.
Yes.
Very, very good fun.
Dying was surprisingly fun.
Again, thank you so much for cheering. I think it's Cheering or Chibbing Grove. for the map. This map is amazing.